Welcome back, guys, to another Procreate tutorial. In today's video, I'll be doing a simple overview of Procreate's features and tools. Some of the tools in Procreate may be difficult for beginners to use and to also know what those tools are used for. So I'll be briefly explaining the purpose of the tools to help minimize any confusion. You can always go back to this Procreate tutorial as a reference guide. So stick around, guys, and in a few moments, I'll be showing you the basic tools of Procreate. Welcome back, everyone. So let's get straight into the Procreate tutorial. The first thing we're going to do is look at this toolbar up here next to gallery, and you'll see a wrench symbol right here, which is called the actions button. There's a lot you can do with the actions tool. You can add images. You can also add text to your artwork. You can edit your canvas as well as share images and layers. You can also record time-lapse videos and also customize your interface as well and your touch controls. Now there's a lot more things that you can do with the actions button, which I'll be covering in future videos. If I were to cover all of the things that you could do with the actions button, this Procreate tutorial would run for too long and would make it very confusing for beginners. For now, the important things for Procreate beginners to know is the list I've provided on the screen for each of the tools. Next, we have the adjustments tool up here that looks like a magical wand icon. The adjustments tool allows you to polish your artwork and helps you create professional effects for your images. There are a lot of effects in the adjustments tool that I'll be showing you how to use in the future, such as blur and sharpen, and another popular one is glitch. So I'm just quickly going to choose the glitch effect just to give you an example of how to use glitch. You'll find this pretty handy for particular artworks. The third icon up here that looks like an S is called the selections tool. You use this tool to isolate parts of your art for repainting or for editing. You can also use it to transform your images as well. A basic example of the selection tool here allows you to cut around images like so before choosing an effect from the bottom toolbar. Just like the other tools, I'll go into an in-depth explanation in my future Procreate videos. Next, we have the transform button. Clicking on the transform button selects the contents of your current layer, and it will also bring up the transform toolbar at the bottom of your canvas. So when you click on this tool, the image that's selected is based on the image that you currently have selected in the layers section. Over here on the top right side, we have another set of important tools that we can use here in Procreate. The first tool over here that looks like a brush is the brush library. All the brushes here are organized into theme categories. There are a lot of default brushes that come with your Procreate app. In addition to the default brushes, you can also edit, organize, and create your own brushes. If you'd like to know how to create your own brushes in Procreate, you can check out my Procreate brushes tutorial, which I'll leave a link up above. I'm just going to show you an example of some of the default brushes from the brush library. There's a lot of really cool default brushes that you can play around with. The next icon looks like a finger, and this is actually called the smudge tool or the smudge brush. It allows you to smudge colors or parts of your artwork. With the help of my mascot, Butternut, I'm going to show you a rough example of what the smudge tool can do. See how it pushes the colors in the direction of your brush stroke. On the right, we have the erase tool. As the name suggests, you can use it to delete the mistakes that you've made. Now here's an example of what the erase tool can do. I'm just gonna erase parts of my character away. The next tool is called layers. The layers tool lets you stack elements of your images on top of each other. They also let you paint overlapping objects without having to alter or change any of the work that you've already done. In addition to that, you can also edit, remove, and delete and recolor any of your elements, giving you the ability to be freely creative. To give a simple example of how layers work, I'm going to create a new layer above Butternut, and I'm going to draw something in this top layer here. So I've decided to draw a green heart over Butternut. Then if we look at layers again, you'll see that I can quickly turn off the green heart without affecting Butternut underneath. The last tool on the right is the colors tool. Procreate designed their color tool to offer artists multiple color interfaces. Now what this means for us artists is that we have multiple options to choose, save, and adjust our colors that best work for us. If we click on the colors tool, you'll see that we have a spectrum of colors. inside a color wheel. The outside of the color wheel lets you choose a particular color, and the inside of the color wheel lets you choose the lighter or darker shades of the color that you chose on the outside of the color wheel. So for example, I'm going to choose this purple here, and as you guys can see, we have different shades of purple that we can choose from in the middle here. Over here on the left side, we have the brush size tool. What you can do with this is you can adjust the size of your brush. So to give you an example, I'm gonna start with a smaller sized brush, and I'm gonna do a brush stroke like this. So you can see that our brush stroke is quite thin. But if I increase the percentage of the brush size, we can create a thicker stroke. And if we put the brush size all the way to 100%, you can see that we have a much thicker brush stroke. So you can clearly see the difference when I adjust the brush size tool. The tool just underneath it is called the Opacity tool. So I'm just quickly going to give you some examples. So I'm going to make a brush stroke here, and you can see that this brush stroke is a full red. So by adjusting the opacity, you'll see differences in how transparent the colors will be. The lower the percentage I choose, the more transparent our color becomes. Thanks for watching, guys. I hope this Procreate tutorial was able to give you a basic reference on what the tools are and what they do. I will be creating more in-depth tutorials for each of these tools in the future. You can always come back to this tutorial as a base reference in case you want to review any of the basic tools. Please help support this channel by liking, commenting, sharing, and subscribing to Mad Chen. You'll be helping to feed Butternut here some honey as well. Alright, so thanks for watching, guys. I'll see you in the next Procreate tutorial.